So what's going on, guys? It's JM, it's Beatboxing. Make sure you guys subscribe to the channel before you click on 20 of my videos. Also, comment below in the comment section if you guys have any opinions of what I'm saying in any of my videos. Like always, it is appreciated if you guys could drop me a quick sub or two on my channel. So, former Unified Cruiserweight Champion of the World and former WBA Heavyweight Champion David Haye has recently split with trainer Shane McGuigan. We all know that him and Shane McGuigan parted on mutual terms, saying that the best thing for David Haye going forward is them not working together. They feel like they're not right for each other, boxer and coach wise. So David Haye has been looking for another trainer for his next comeback, because we all know David Haye ruptured his Achilles tendon against Tony Bellew, and he was stopped in the 11th round after basically having to fight half the fight with one leg. And on social media, David Haye looks like his recovery is going well, and he says that he'll be back in the ring soon. He isn't naming any opponents and that anytime soon, but apparently David Haye's been linked with Cuban trainer Ismael Salas. And people might not be familiar with that name, but Salas trains WBA super bantamweight champion Guillermo Rigondeaux. He trains WBA lightweight champion Jorge Linares, who recently defeated Anthony Crolla back to back. He's trained Cuban fighters like Yuriorkas Gamboa and, what's the fighter called at 140 pounds? Rancis Barthelemy. He trained him as well. He's also trained national teams in the amateurs, Salas. So it's a very random pick by David Haye, but he obviously must have seen Salas train fighters like Jorge Linares, and he must be impressed with what Salas is doing. And it'd be interesting to see how Salas can help David Haye, because David Haye, in my opinion, at 36 years old, needs to try and develop a style best fitted for his age now. Because David Haye, his whole career, he's fought based on speed and reflexes. David Haye is a counterpuncher, and he's relied on the speed and reflexes to be able to make that effective in fights. That's why David Haye has knocked out so many people, due to the speed and the power that he possesses and the reflexes. But since his comeback, David Haye hasn't really looked sharp, and that's not really surprising. He's 36 years old, and he definitely didn't look sharp in the Tony Bellew fight, obviously, because he was probably carrying injuries before that fight, David Haye. But he thought that he'd probably just bang Tony Bellew out in a couple of rounds. But when that didn't happen, then David Haye's body just went out on him. And that was sad to see, because David Haye, a few years ago, well, back in 2008, 2007, was a very popular fighter, and he was respected by a lot of people. I used to like David Haye as a fighter. He used to be a fighter I enjoyed watching. And then when I saw him fight Tony Bellew, and the way he was just breaking down, it was sad to see. Like, you were just thinking, David, come on, son, just call it a day. But obviously he wanted to continue until he was stopped in the 11th round. And a lot of people are calling for David Haye to retire. He thinks he can still go on. Do I think David Haye will become heavyweight champion again? No. I don't think David Haye will become heavyweight champion again, unless he fights somebody like Fraser Quendo for the WBA regular title. But against the big boys, I don't think David Haye has it in him anymore, against guys like Anthony Joshua and Deontay Wilder. Don't get me wrong, David Haye still hits very hard, and if he lands on you, it could be lights out for you. But I don't know, I just don't see David Haye having it anymore. But Ismael Salas might be able to help him try and make some sort of comeback. Salas is a very good trainer. He's trained a lot of high level fighters. Jorge Linares has looked fantastic with Ismael Salas. Like, that performance against Anthony Crolla was a fantastic performance by Jorge Linares. So Salas is a very experienced trainer with high level fighters. So it'll be interesting to see how he can help David Haye, because David Haye does definitely have holes. And if he really wants to try and compete at a high level, David Haye, he really needs to sort him out. But can he sort him out at 36 years old with reoccurring injuries? I'm not very confident at all. But comment below in the comment section, what do you guys think of this? It's JM, it's Beatboxing.